Hey guys, this is the Zebu by Matt Catcher. I'm re-recording this intro because I messed up my recording earlier. So, this might seem like your typical space engineer's truck, but there's something special about this truck. So, you know, on the surface level, you got all your typical truck features like the towing mechanism and the camera and, you know, all the truck stuff, but well, if you look over here, this is actually engineered to be like an actual truck with, you know, an openable cabin and stuff. And when the truck is open like this, you can repair the engine and some other components as well. The hinges are kind of shaky, but you know, this is fine. And well, when the truck is in this position, you can actually get inside the passenger seat without a jetpack. I'm gonna close the cabin here. And there we go. Isn't that super cool? We also got the instruction manual inside the truck itself, so you don't need to read the manual on the Steam Workshop page or whatever. Alright, before I show you the performance of the truck, I just want to mention this, you know, this feature with how they use the panels to shape the headlights of the truck. Angry truck. Which, you know, is always cool. I've seen some vehicles do this as well. And to the center here, we got the, you know, the spot for the license plate. And well, the bumper is heavy armor, so, you know, there's a good attention to details. They also use these corner LCD panels for some of the lights there. Oh, and the truck cost 2750 PCO with 410 blocks. On the bottom toolbar, you know, you got your usual controls for the trailer control and for the truck itself. So, you know, all the usual stuff. The amazing thing about the truck though is the handling is very well configured. As you guys can see here, even though I'm doing the maximum turning speed of the truck at the maximum possible speed, the truck doesn't get flipped over. So, a very well configured handling by the creator there. Alright, let's go back to my previous recording now. I kind of want to test the carrying capability of the truck, but I don't have like a trailer. So I guess I'll just use like, you know, a large cargo container. There we go. Yeah, this is fine. Filling this up with ice. The truck is actually fine though. Well, you know, I guess we can just carry the empty cargo box there. Surprisingly, even with the even with the large cargo container back there, the truck is still rather stable. Gotta be careful with the turning though. Can I stop the here goes the bumper. But you know, considering what we are doing with the truck right now, this is rather impressive. What's broken? Oh, I broke some hinges and headlight. Alright, let's see how well this truck handles going down a cliff. I cannot get out to third person. Oh, there we go. Come on. We're still moving. Come on. I couldn't turn left there. We're still alive though. There goes all the power. I survive. Look at the damage though. I feel like if there's any improvement to be made to this truck, is that, well, maybe some of the gyroscopes need to be on the cap itself. So, you know, if there's like some kind of accident back there, we would still have some gyroscopic control. Because right now I think all the gyroscopes are back there. And well, I guess we can have some backup batteries to the front as well. And I think that will help with the vehicle survivability a little bit. That's a pretty survivable cabin though. Look at that. Alright, I added a passenger to the truck. I'm gonna load the container with artillery shells. Maybe not that many. Maybe just 1,000 artillery shells. No, I guess I can adjust the suspension, but that will mess with the handling a little. It's fine. And now, if I put in the, it won't go down. Come on. So if I put like counterweight to the front, right? And now, if we fill up the container with artillery shells, then it won't be falling down. 500 artillery shells. Oh, there you go. Alright, this should be fine. I turn off my god mode. Alright, here it goes. Let's say that we're some. No, not again. Oh, and there we go. It's kind of impressive how the truck is still able to move with all those X. I reduce it to only 100 artillery shells. This is working a lot better now. Alright, let's say that we're some kind of rebel trying to bring down an evil empire. So we're gonna deliver this truck full of explosives to that enemy base over there. Here it goes. Oh, this is gonna be a little bit hard because I cannot really move sideways without flipping the truck. Come on. Almost there. No, almost there. Whew. Oh. Oh. Yeah, that didn't go too well. Alright, just one more try here. I'm gonna try to gain some speed first. Come on. Alright. Turn right. Turn left. Slow down a little. There we go. We get it. Ooh. I don't think this is a working strategy. But what if you put like artillery turrets on the container? No. Oof. Maybe just like a single turret on top of the container. Yeah, there we go. That's more like it. Alright, let's roll. Removing the speed limit and I'm gonna increase the strength as well. We will not fail. We will not fail. Alright, here goes. Oh, there we go. We're shooting. Come on, keep shooting. Oh, not the reload time. Keep shooting. I'm getting out of here. I don't want to work for the rebels anymore. But yeah, well, as you guys can see there, the carrying performance of the the truck is pretty impressive considering, you know, it's a small grid truck, and if you actually use the truck in a reasonable manner, it would probably work a lot better. So yeah, that's the Zebu by Madcatcher. You guys can find the link in the description below. Where's the other side of the truck, by the way? Wait, what? Yeah, I don't really see this debris here. Oh, is this all that's left? I guess some of them despawn. That explosion with the artillery shells was pretty crazy though. It like obliterated the whole truck.